now potpourri.
Kevin Turner. I'm a 12th grader at Mainland High School, class 2016.
My name is Nation McDuffie, and I am in 12th grade, my senior year.
My name is Tamara Lowe, and I'm a senior.
My name is LaKira Slater. I'm a senior in Mainland High School.
My plans after high school, attending college.
I'm not going to college. I'm going to attend FAM and then transfer to Florida State.
I'm going to attend DSC for 2 years and probably transfer to USF. Stay focused, get motivated, be determined, don't give up. It's not the end of the world if you do mess up, just try to fix your mistakes.
Stay focused, stay motivated.
To just stay determined, focused, you know, just get your work done so it can be easier your last year, you know.
My advice to the freshmen, stay focused your freshman year, because like it really messes you up if you don't stay focused throughout all your years, and like don't try to slack. If you're gonna play any sport, do it early and don't wait.
An everlasting friendship. One of the most beautiful things a young girl can have. But what happens once the newness rubs off, when the spark no longer ignites? Here we present to you the trials and tribulations of longtime friendships.
One thing I can't stand that Peyton does is that she chews so loud.
Could you please not do that?
Okay, one thing that I hate... One thing that I hate that Lisa does is that she freaking fangirls all the time, and like it's just over obsessive.
True. Peyton. Oh my gosh, they posted it. Having heard his album, it is so good. Honestly, I've never heard anything better in my life.
Another thing that I hate that Peyton does is that she walks into a room so loud.
I don't do that. No. That's not a thing I do.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Hey, Mr. Cardino, how's it going?
Fine. How are you?
Lisa never shows me any affection whatsoever. She likes to be in her own little world, and I'm just like, hey, Lisa, and she just, you know, pushes me away, and it makes me really feel bad about myself, and she's not a good friend, so that's...
Okay.
Alright. Hey, Lisa!
Why would you throw a baby?
Yeah,
wait,
what? No!
No!
I
wasn't aware that we need...
I'm gonna kick my shoes off. I'm gonna let...
Oh, sorry. Okay. She hits me with the broom.
Okay, y'all ready?
Yeah.
Micaiah, stop. And she doesn't consider anybody's feelings.
I Irish dance on command sometimes.
Wait, do that again?
No.
She said, hey!
Mainland, it's been 1 year and now you're 1 year smarter. Let's go and see how smart you are. But first,
all right, let's go.
Then I'm gonna ask you guys a couple questions, all right? Test your knowledge.
Go ahead.
All right. Which is heavier, a pound of cotton or a pound of stone?
They're the same.
Stone.
Pound of stone.
Pound of cotton.
Pound of stone.
Pound of stone.
Stone.
Pound of stone.
I think that's stone, boy.
Pound of stone.
Pound of cotton.
They're the same. It's a pound.
They both wear the same.
Cotton, because they both wear a pound. They're both the same.
And they're both a pound, so it should be the same thing, you feel?
What is the capital of North America?
North America?
I don't know. Okay, money. I don't know.
What's the capital of North America?
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C.
What is the capital of North America?
Washington, D.C.
The United States.
I'm not a senior, so I don't know that yet.
I don't know.
America? America? North America?
What is the capital of North America?
Washington, D.C.
Washington, D.C. Capital of North America? What is the capital of North America?
There is no capital of North America.
South America?
North?
Africa?
Africa? North America.
North
America. Ain't no capital in North America.
Capital of North America.
It's a lot of capitals. What you mean?
Okay. If yes spells Y-E-S, what does E-Y-E-S stand for?
Eyes.
Eyes.
What are you? E-Y-E-S. E-S.
What the heck?
Eyes.
I couldn't tell you the answer to that. I don't know.
Eyes.
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 See?
Eyes.
Isa.
Eyes.
Wait, what?
Eyes.
Yes, what does E-Y-E-S spell?
E-Y-E-S. E-E-S.
Your mom has four kids, north, south, east. What's the fourth child's name?
Wait, north, east, west?
West.
All right.
East.
West, but my mama don't have four kids.
It's me.
I'm the fourth child.
Man.
Jose, I'm right here, baby.
West.
West.
West, I guess.
Me.
West.
Stop it.
West?
West.
How long did it take to go 80 miles per hour?
3 seconds, I guess.
I don't know.
Like 10 seconds, I guess.
I don't know. How long did it take? I mean, it don't. How long? Wait, what? What was the question?
Take to go 80 miles.
I don't know. 80. 80 minutes?
Miles per hour.
Depends on what kind of car you're driving.
80 miles. No, I meant 8. Whoa. 8. Wait.
Mainland, you did a good job, but.
Hey, ask me what you doing, bro. Try to be like me, bro. You can't be like me, bro. That was
tough. That's all
the time. You can't do that no more, bro.
Hi, my name is Wyatt. I am a proud father of a beautiful baby girl named Hayden. I love her very much and I'd do anything for her. She's my world and nothing will ever change that or come in between me and her. The downside is that I'm only 17 years old and I still attend high school. It is very difficult to multitask at such a young age, especially when you are trying to get the career you want in life. It is very possible to do so, but it is a lot harder to achieve. You can believe that you can still be young and do the things you love, but what you really come face to face with is that all of you goes all to your baby. That is your priority. You are no longer a teenager in the eyes of the law and society. You are now considered an adult. You need a job, you need resources, you always have to know what to do, and you always do what's best for your baby. Everything you do is an impact on your child. Something of a baby's memory now won't be remembered when they're older, but the impact you make will form what your child's perspective and outlook on people are in life. It is extremely hard to do what you love. That passion of what defines you is postponed or is achieved at a slower pace. To be honest, there's a chance you just won't be able to reach your goal. But truly, whose fault is that? What you are striving for, doing what you want and need to do, all at once isn't easy. I don't care what people say about being too young. To me, that doesn't matter, unless you're not mature. If you're not mature, then definitely do not have kids. Being a teen and having a kid is just difficult because your life's not settled out. Wait to bring a kid into this world for the better of their future and yours. Get your life in check before getting a chance to experience what parenthood is.
Now you're here today with
Katia Anthony.
And today I'll be asking her, how was it? First question, do you have any special memories that will always stay with you?
Yeah, I have a couple memories of, because this is my first year here, so like football, yeah. Football season, like all throughout the football season, we have the football plays and stuff, and hanging out, you know, getting to know the coaches and getting to know people. That's the memories I'll have, and you know, getting to know people and the teachers, that's the memories I'll always have.
Do you have any special memories that will always stay with you?
That's hard. I don't know. It was good memories, boy. A lot of fights.
Hi, I'm Lisha. You're here with
Ayana.
To ask you a few questions about how do you have any special memories that will always stay with you?
No.
And do you have any special memories that would all stay with you?
The new book concert, homecoming. I didn't go to prom. And I was surprised when we got vandalized.
Alright. What is a memory that will stick with you for a good while?
Homecoming. Best days ever.
If you could do it all over again, would you?
Would I do my whole senior year? No. Last week, I'm done.
If you could do it all, like the whole freshman year over again, would you?
No.
If you could do it all over again, would you?
No.
And if you could do it all over again, would you?
Junior year? No. Freshman and sophomore year? Yes. All
right, thank you. And if you could do it all over again, would you?
No. I'm trying to leave and venture off into a new chapter.
What will you remember most?
I guess, that's a good question.
I guess having a good time
with friends and, you know, getting work done.
What will you remember most about Mainland High School?
That's funny that you answered it. The funniest thing I remember about Mainland High School was today, this morning.
Was it like?
No, it was like
the sea breeze.
Yeah,
I don't know who did. That was crazy.
That was,
what will you remember most about Mainland High School?
All the lovely teachers.
What will you be looking forward to after high school?
Getting further in my education so I can, you know,
be what I want to be.
That's good. And what will you be looking forward to next year?
Being able to go off campus.
How was your freshman year at Mainland High School?
It was good while I lasted.
Oh. Okay. So how was your freshman year?
Horrible.
How was your junior year?
It was good. But it was my last 2 years.
Alright. So how was your sophomore year?
Well, it wasn't how I expected it to be, but I managed to get through.
Mr. Rowe, can you tell me what's on your mind?
Call me Eddie. I like being called that.
Okay, Eddie Rowe. Can you tell me what's on your mind?
I just remember my first day at school. How special it was for me. Boy, was I wrong. Arriving there for the first time, it was special.
Okay guys, we have a new student in class today.
Please make Edward Rowe feel as welcome as possible.
I felt empty when I arrived there. That was until I met her.
Excuse me, what's your name again?
It's Edward.
Is it okay if I call you Eddie?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
Her beauty was astonishing.
Know more about the man who made it.
It was important to me. It was until I met him.
Hey, watch where you're going.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to.
Who are you texting?
Nobody.
Who's that gift for?
Nobody either.
Is it for Micaiah?
Can you please give me that back?
Come on, what's in it then? Photography, huh? That's your talent?
Try to turn away from this. You need to get your revenge. That is not the way I would do that. That's your problem. You're weak. You're a pushover. You need to take action. There's no further discussion. No, not again. Not again. No, I am not weak. You need to take him out.
Thought you'd be back. What's the matter?
Okay, Mr. Rowe.
Calm
down.
Hi, my name is Angelina Del Rosso, and to say my life has been interesting is an understatement.
So, Angelina, please tell us the first thing that happened to you when you were 7 years old.
When I was 7 years old, I fell 30 feet from a skyscraper. ski lift chair and shattered my lower back. I had fragments of my spinal cord and fractured 1, 2, 4, and 5 of my lumbar. I was told that I may never walk again, let alone live a normal life.
But here you are, walking, talking, and living a normal life, right?
Right.
Okay, but of course, some other things happened too, right?
Yes.
So tell me what happened when you were 13 years old.
When I was 13 years old, I was bit by a 6-foot black-tip shark and almost lost my leg due to infection.
But?
I still have my leg.
Yay, you still have your leg. Good, okay. So what happened when you were 16 years old?
When I was 16 years old, I was playing a high school softball game, and I got a line drive to the face, lost 2 teeth, shattered my chin, and broke my jaw.
But they managed to put Humpty Dumpty back together again, right?
Yes.
What a pretty smile. And now that you're 17 years old, is life normal, or did something else happen?
I got bit by a snake going to get my fishing pole.
Was it poisonous?
Yes.
They had to give you anti-venom?
Yes.
Where did you get bit?
On my ankle.
On your ankle. Okay, so now you're a junior in high school, right?
Yes.
And you hope to graduate next year, right?
I'm gonna graduate next year.
Okay, is there any way we might have to put you in a bubble for your senior year?
There might be a slim chance.
We're glad you survived everything. Congratulations.
Thank you.
By the way, Angelina, why are we doing this interview while you're sitting up there on a cliff?
You know what? You gotta live and let live.
Are you ready? A is the father of B, but B is not the son of A. How's that possible?
A is the father of B. That B is not the son of A. I don't know. What?
A is the B of father, but B is not the son of A. How's that possible?
I don't know.
Oh, cuz, like, you know how 1, 2, and 3, they all numbers, but they not really numbers.
Because he had relations with somebody else?
Gotta be the mama.
I don't know.
Second question. A rooster laid an egg on top of the barn roof. Which way did it roll?
To the side. Down the road.
It had to roll forward. Like real round, so I guess it's gonna fall like on top of or on the ground, really, you feel me? Because it just rolled off. So.
Left. If there are 6 apples and you take away 4, how many do you have?
2 apples.
2.
I think so. 25.
2.
2.
What goes up and down but still remains in the same place?
Me.
No.
Up and down but remains in the same place.
Has a head and a tail, but nobody.
I don't know. Oh, wait. I do know this one. Rashika.
Head and tail.
Oh. What has a head and a tail and nobody? Ariane.
Mickey Mouse.
A strange creature.
legacies. Family. Wait, see, like a family. A quarter, yeah.
Successful, but not too successful, otherwise you will threaten the man. Because I am female, I am expected to aspire to marriage. I'm expected to make my life choices, always keeping in mind that marriage is the most important. Now, marriage can be a source of joy and love and mutual support, but why do we teach girls to aspire to marriage and we don't teach boys the same? We raise girls to see each other as competitors, not for jobs or for accomplishments, which I think can be a good thing, but for the attention of men. We teach girls that they cannot be sexual beings in the way that boys are. feminist, a person who believes in the social, political, and economic equality of the sexes.
You wake up, housed up, round round in it, blossom on it, this diamond, my diamond, this rock, my rock.
My sister, who's so mean to me, and my brother, he makes fun of me, he hates me, and anytime I try to do anything, anytime I try to push him away, my dad yells at me. He's never cared about me the same way he cared about me. I was homeschooled, like third and fourth grade, and I went back to school in fifth grade. So everyone in fifth grade, they made fun of me, and they laughed about the way I talked. Everyone made fun of me because I was a girl that dressed like a boy. And I always tried to make new friends, and no matter what, there was someone making fun of me and my friends. To this day, there are people that still make fun of me. People that say rude things about me because I like girls. And it just hurts, and between everything going on at home and everything going on here, I cry every day. Whether it's at home or I can't hold it back and I go to the bathroom so I can cry on the floor, I still can't hold back the tears.
So when I was in kindergarten, I had one friend, which happened to me, be my dog. But every day I went to the school, I had a terrible speech impediment. And no matter what, it didn't matter if it was kids or the teachers would make fun of me. Even the kids who were made fun of me. And that went on for quite a while. But when I got home, it was no better, because my dad would more than likely be abusing my mom. And when my brother got old enough, he started abusing him. And then when my sister did, started abusing Paul.
Okay, so all of this happened when I was in middle school, in about the 8th grade. There was this guy, can't exactly remember his name, but I would sometimes call him names because of what he would do to me and my friend. Me and my friend, we're like atheists, which means that we don't really believe in any religion. But this guy, he was a hardcore Christian guy. And so whenever he would see me and my friend in the class that we shared, he would always call us Satanists, and he would try to like hit us and attack us. And sometimes he would even take our composition books from that class, and he would try to start ripping them up, saying we had written demonic things in them when we were just writing our short stories. And he even took one of her binders one time and took scissors to it and completely jacked it all up. And she had made like pretty like flower designs and everything on it. In my old school, I had to ride bus all the time. On that bus, we were forced to sit together with all middle school students and preschool and elementary school students. All the middle school students were forced into the back to each other, where the seats were filled up to 3 to a seat. My experience was the part where not a group of maybe 1 or 2 people, it was to the point where 7 people were torturing me on a bus where I used to have really, really long hair down to my hips, and they would stick foot-long pieces of duct tape in my hair, where they would stuff gum, chewed up gum in my hair, where they would trash my phone, where they would take my backpack and take scissors to it. And it got to the point where the school would do nothing. they would tell my mom that we're still reviewing the evidence, that something needed to be figured out, that the boys were innocent. Because it didn't happen just once. It happened multiple times, to where the point where I would come home crying, where I cut all of my hair off. I felt like I literally wanted to die every single day that I had to go in the morning and afternoon to this school. But the school did nothing.
And I heard your prayers from far below, but down in hell, how could you know? I listened every word you said, I heard ya. But after this, I bled the fifth. Before my fall, after you lived, I swore I heard you say the hallelujah.
How long have you been teaching at Mainland High School, and what are the subjects you taught?
I have been teaching here at Mainland High School 29 years. When I first started teaching here, I taught a couple of classes of English, I taught speech classes, and then I started teaching drama.
How do you feel about retiring after this year?
Well, it's been a good long run. I've really, really loved being a teacher. I've always told people I have two careers I really love. One is teaching high school kids, and the other is being a professional entertainer and performer. And I always say many people can't find one career they love, let alone two.
Do you plan on traveling or doing things you've never done before during your retirement?
I do hope to do some more traveling, and there are some things I would like to do. I was a theater major in college, so I'd like to do more acting, and I'm gonna work on my music, play a little golf, play with my grandkids, so I'm really looking forward to that.
What advice do you give the teacher that's going to fill in for you?
Well, whoever takes over this position, first of all, you gotta be a lot tougher than I was. kids today will take advantage, so if you don't lay the law down and stroke that referral when they don't do what you tell them to do after a number of occasions, you gotta put the hammer down.
Are there any people you're going to miss the most after you retire?
Well, first of all, I've been blessed to work at the same high school my entire teaching career. First of all, I want to say that I have had the pleasure of working with a tremendous number of incredibly wonderful educators and administrators. So I'm going to miss a lot of those people. But most importantly, I'm going to miss the interaction with the really wonderful students who care about learning and care about getting ahead in the world and educating themselves so they can be really good, productive people. So some of the things I really like doing with the kids is having fun with them in the hallway, especially trying to get them in a good mood and to pay attention and to smile, because this is a wonderful time in their lives. All right, don't forget, you're gonna bring me some lunch, right?
Yes, sir.
All right, that's good. Bye.
Bye.
See you later. Bye. Can you bring me some lunch?
Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah, sure? I will.
Bye. How about you?
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Bye.
How you doing? How you doing? Good, good. You guys doing okay?
Yes, sir.
Come on, smile. Smile. There you go. Okay, so now the things that drive me crazy. First of all, littering. Oh my God. If their homes look the way they treat this campus, what a mess. One of the things I don't like is when I give kids directions and they don't follow them. When I say the equipment has to be back at a certain time and they don't follow them, because some kids think they can do whatever they darn please. And that's one of the things that bugs me that I will not miss. Number two, walking on the right side. Oh my gosh, if they drive their cars the way they walk around here, we're in trouble. So, some of the other things that kind of bug me around here that I'm not going to miss when I retire are, for instance, playing with your phone in my class when you know you're not supposed to, right? Now, if I could just write them up, I'd be writing referrals all day long. What I want to do is confiscate the phone and sell it on eBay and give all the money to poor kids in foreign countries. Put it away! Number three, some kids are oblivious to the world. Headphones in, cell phone in hand, they don't see what's going on around them. Friends walk by and say hello, I say hello, nobody pays attention. That's sad. Oh, I love life, I love people. I love being around people. But let me tell you what really bugs me sometimes. Go ahead. Hey, hi Ariana. Ariana? Ariana! She's a good kid. But she just walked by and ignored everything in the world because she's got a phone in her hand and her headphones in her ears and she's oblivious to everything around her. Smell the roses, listen to the birds sing, right? Tell your boyfriend you're taking a break. Oh yeah, and I can't stand when people are trying to get on the elevator when people are trying to get off. Let the people off first, then get on. Common sense. Boy, I'm gonna miss this place.
Keep going, Dylan.
Mom! All right, it's here. Come on.
What?
Thank you.
2017, Miss Mainland is Naomi Kamau.